Hello everyone, today we're going to create this sports poster using Pixalab and Snapseed. Okay, so first, let's clear our background and change our image size to a poster size. Next, let's just create a text. I'll type in the letter A here. I'll just increase the size. Set the font to Obelix Pro. I'll still increase the size to make the height cover the full canva. Just place it at the side here. Create a shape and make it very small. Send it outside the canva. Now merge the text and shape together. Go to texture. Set as the texture and image. All project files are linked in the description in case you want to follow along. Make sure the image doesn't repeat. You can crop it or scale it big like I've done. Next, I'll just import this image here. Rotate it and place it behind the other image. Make sure it doesn't come outside that area. Lock your layers. I'll import my third image. I'll also send it to the back. I'll import another image. I'll just crop this one. Place it at the bottom and send it to the back. Next, I'll import the pictures of the players. Just place all of them as I will be doing if you want to get similar result. Notice how I send the images at the side behind the one at the center. It gives it a more realistic look. Next, click on stickers and then tap anywhere on the canva to select this particular sticker. Change the color to black. Duplicate it and just merge the two together. I'll just place it behind this player's head. Reduce the opacity to about 30%. I'll add a new text. I'll just type in there something related to Arsenal. The font is Stretch Sans. I'll just reduce the size. Go to curves and increase the bending to about 95%. I'll copy it and just rotate this one 180 degrees. Position this one so they both form something like a circle. Now merge them together. Just scale it down and ace it at the bottom right. Create a new shape, make it cover the full screen. Set the color to black. Now reduce the opacity to 21%. Just send it behind all the player images. I'll add another text. This one is for the team name. The font is Tandel. I'll make it bold. Set the color to red. I'll go to background and enable it. Set the color to white. Now just drop the padding on the top and bottom and increase the one on the left and right. I'll just reduce the size of the text. Let's just move the players so there's enough space at the edge here. Just adjust the background to fit the current size of the text. I'll just move this to the edge. I think it's not hitting the edge of the Canva. I'll add a new text. The font is Stretch Sans. I'll set the color to white and reduce the size. I'll just arrange the two texts together. Next, I'll just import an image of a grunge background. I'll crop it to fit the size of the Canva and just increase the size. Go to Erase Color and erase the white color from it. Set the color to white. Now, place it behind the players but above the other images. Next, I'll import an image of a splash. I'll just reduce its size and set the color to white. I'll also send it behind the players. I'll just duplicate it and place it at other areas. Next, create a triangle. Set the color to a gradient red. You can copy the hex code I'm using. Go to Emboss and enable it. You can adjust the values the way I'm doing, or you can do whatever suits you here. I'll send it behind the players too. I'll just duplicate it and position this other one at the other edge. Let's just reduce the size of this text. For the shapes, I'll just make them 3D shapes. I'll adjust the X and Y rotation values to make the 3D shape more visible. Just make sure it's the same for the other shape. Alright, save your image and let's head over to Snapseed. In Snapseed, just import the design. First, go to Tune Image. Reduce the brightness to -10 and increase the contrast to 32. Go to Grudge, set the style value to 1191. Set the brightness to 1, the contrast to 25, the saturation to 35 and the texture strength to 32. Go to View Edits and select Grudge. Now with the value at 50, just brush over the text. You can drop the value and brush some areas also. Next, go to Grudge again. Set the style value to 1191. The brightness to 100, the contrast to 100, the saturation to 40 and the texture strength to 45. Make sure you're using the Grudge preset 4. Go to View Edits and select the new Grudge. With the value at 50, just brush over the edges of the design. Next, go to Tonal Contrast. Set the high tones to 68, mid tones to 57, low tones to 66, protect shadows to 15 and protect highlights to 10. Go to HDR Scape, with the people preset, reduce the filter strength to 15 and the saturation to 4. Go to details and increase the structure to 19. Go to black and white and select the dark preset style. Leave everything as they are and select OK. Go to view edits and select black and white. With the value at 100, brush over the left side of the design as I'm doing. Next, go to brush and select dodge and burn. With the value at 10, brush over the 3D shape. Select exposure and make sure the value is 1.0, brush over the shape again. Select saturation and with the value at 10 brush over the shape too. Do the same for the 3D shape at the other side. I'll just speed this up. Go to grain, select the AO4 preset. Reduce the style strength a bit and adjust the grain value. Go to curves. Adjust the red, blue and green curves just as I'm doing. Enter white balance and increase the temperature to 4. Go to tonal contrast and increase the values again. Go to HDR Scape and reduce the filter strength to 5. Go to details and increase the structure value. Go to frame, select frame 18 and set the frame width to -33. Select vignette and leave the outer brightness at -50. Go to portrait, I'll just allow it to load. I'll use the combo 3. You can adjust the values. Select details and increase the structure again. And that's it, you can save your work. Alright, we've come to the end of this video. I hope you found it helpful. Please if you did, kindly like, share, comment and subscribe to this channel for more value. Click a video on screen to get more knowledge on Pixelab and smartphone graphic design. Click on my social links in the description to follow me on social media and to join my Telegram and WhatsApp group chat to get more information.